today I want to show you how you can easily rewrite existing links in WordPress and add the rel sponsored or rel UGC or whatever link attributes there are to your existing links. And the reason why I've decided doing that is because in September of 2019, Google announced new link attributes that in some cases can replace the old nofollow links. And again, two of those are rel equals sponsored and rel equals user-generated content or UGC. And I was particularly interested in the sponsored because in the past, I would mark all of my affiliated, monetized, paid, etc. links as nofollow to keep it simple. But since Google introduced a change now, I want to make it as easy as possible for Google's crawlers to understand my content and the types of links that I use. And in addition to that, I also want to be as transparent as possible to my visitors and end users to help them understand what links are affiliated or potentially sponsored and which ones aren't. I think that's important from a trust and transparency perspective. So in the past, I used a plugin called External Links to automatically tag my external sponsored links with nofollow. Unfortunately, the plugin, as of a few weeks ago, doesn't exactly do what I wanted to do. And I've submitted a feature request, but I was not patient enough to wait for them to add that. So I decided to do it myself. And the way you can add it's a simple code snippet basically that I've added to WordPress that can rewrite those links very easily. So let me show you how it's done. The first thing you want to do is you want to install the code snippets plugin. I have it already installed, so it's not going to allow me to actually go through the installation here, but it's fairly simple. You know, code snippets, you search for it here, and then you install and activate it. And once you do, you see that little snippets menu item here in the sidebar. So you can click on add new. You give your snippet a name like rewrite affiliate links, and then you paste the code. Now, obviously, you cannot copy and paste the code from a video here, but I'm going to link a blog article in the description below that has that code. So just grab it from there and paste it in. Fairly simple. So let me walk you through what that code does. It might seem a little daunting, especially if you're not familiar with regular expressions and functions and some of the other stuff in PHP, but it is a little, it's straightforward at the end of the day. So basically what it does is what I do is I've created a function that I call rewrite affiliate links. And you can call it however you want to, it doesn't really matter. And that function takes one argument and that is content. And you can also call that however you want to. I call it content because it takes the content of WordPress. So whenever you know someone visits a post or a page, the HTML code basically that gets sent to the user's browser is the content. So all of that I hand over to my function. And then what the variable here basically does is it gets populated with a it calls a regular expression that matches any URLs in the content. And a URL is typically identified by an opening A tag. So, you know, the A tag is an HTML tag that identifies a link and a closing A tag. And so anything in between the opening and the closing A tag with the href attribute somewhere in the middle, and that could be any other content either before or after that href attribute, doesn't really matter, would match. So it finds all the links basically in the content, and then it calls a function for every link that it finds. And that function in turn matches the link that my regular expression matched against a predefined list of URLs or partial URLs. So these are basically all of my affiliated domains and links. And you don't have to use the full link. So for instance, your amplify.com, I might use amplify.com/SOAR/, something. It doesn't really matter. As long as it contains amplify.com, it would be a match. Or something like this here. Most of my affiliated links that I use the pattern /go/, ABC, and that would redirect them to the actual affiliate link. And I do this because it makes it easy for me to update redirects if my affiliate partners change their link structure on their page, which they do all the time. So bottom line here is I have a comma separated list of URLs or partial URLs that I consider sponsored, paid, monetized, what have you. And that's a simple array at the end of the day. And so I would step through the array from, the first entry to the last entry, and I would compare each entry of the array with the link that was matched by this regular expression. So basically, at the end of the day, every link in every post or page that I have would get piped through this function and compared to my list here. And if there is a match, so here, if I use string pause to find the string basically. And I also use string to lower to convert everything to lowercase. So in case, I use, performance lab with an uppercase P in one of my posts, it would still match. It doesn't matter, if it's uppercase or lowercase. But if it matches, if it finds one of these URLs or partial URLs in my post or page, then it would reassemble that link. So starting with the opening A tag, href equals the URL. So this input basically that I get is an array as well, and it contains the URL as well as the link name, so the part that comes between the opening and closing A tag. So I reassemble that link, I add the rel sponsored no opener tags or attributes, I add the target equals blank, so it opens in a new window, and I add the link name obviously, so the part that comes between the text that's linked basically. And I add this little asterisk to indicate to visitors, so not Google, Google doesn't care about that, but to regular visitors, I indicate that this is a sponsored link. And I'll show you here in a little bit, once we go to my blog, how this is then presented and why it makes it easier for end users then to understand that this is a sponsored link. Now, once we have, if there is no match, so if we don't find a sponsored link, but if we find a link that includes my server's host name, and I use this global variable here, which is a fairly reliable way to determine my own host name. So in my case, michaelkummer.com. So if the link includes michaelkummer.com, then it's an internal link. And I just return it as is. So I don't add anything, rewrite anything. But if it's not an internal link, meaning that it's an external link, but not a sponsored one, then I add the follow no opener attribute, and I also open the link in a new window. But I do these three things basically. I change the link if it's a sponsored link, I change it if it's an external but not a sponsored link, and I leave it as is if it's an internal link. Those are the three things that I do with my links, but you can change and modify that to address a host of different use cases if you like. And then at the very end, I return the content. So basically after all the links have been replaced or not, I return the content to WordPress. And to make this function work, I have to add it as a filter. So I use the add filter function with the content as the first parameter, the name of my function as the second parameter. So whatever you choose up here, use the same name down here. And then an optional priority is the third function parameter. And I use 100 as a priority. I think the default, if you don't use anything, is maybe 10 or 11 or something like that. But I want to make sure that my content filter gets executed at the very end. And because there might be themes and other plugins that use content filters as well that might rewrite links or change links, I want to make sure that mine gets called at the very end so that all of the potential affiliated links get properly adjusted and marked with an asterisk, basically. So that's the code. If you don't see any errors in your code, like for instance, if you have a spelling error here, you would see a red X or indication that there's a parsing error or a syntax error or something. If there is nothing, if everything looks good, you can save the changes and activate the code. You can decide if you want to run the snippet everywhere, only in the admin area, which wouldn't make sense in this case, only on the front end. This is really where it makes sense. We could change that to only run on the front end because I don't need my affiliate links, if there are any, here on the back end. And you can say, run only once, but now we want to keep it that way. You could also increase the priority here to something like 100 if you have different filters that you have. So you can change the priority there, give it a description, whatever, and that's it. Then save and activate. And if you do, I recommend trying this or making at least a backup of your page. So in case you screw something up, you can easily revert back to a previous version or your backup basically that you made. Better yet, do it on a staging page. I use Flywheel as my hosting provider, and they give me a staging environment that I can play around. So in case I fuck up, I don't break my page. If you break something and you can't log into the WordPress plugin anymore, WordPress backend anymore to disable the snippet, you can simply FTP into your page and remove the folder of that snippet plugin, and that should do the trick as well. But so with that said, let's check out how it looks on the front end. So here is my blog, and there are links everywhere, and I don't see anywhere that asterisks, obviously, because all of these are internal links. But let's open this review, for example. And here you can see here on the sidebar with the asterisks, here is how I explain or where I explain how I make money and that I use affiliate links. And you can learn more about how I make money if you want to. And here are internal links. None of those are marked, but here is, for instance, an affiliated link that has the little asterisk. So let's look for one that's in line with the content. So you can see that as well. Those are internal links, as you can see. And here, for instance, this one goes to Amazon, where I bought my Netgear Nighthawk cable modem, and I use Amazon affiliates. So you can see here, this is an affiliated link. If you want to inspect the element, you could also tell here, if you look at the code, rel sponsored no opener, and then the little asterisk here at the end. So this is basically what the code did. And that's really as simple as it is to rewrite your affiliate links and to make sure that Google understands and your end users understand what types of links you're using. If you have any questions, drop me a comment below or shoot me an email. If it doesn't work for you, maybe I can try to help you figure it out. But with that said, thanks for watching this video. Make sure you subscribe and click the notify and alert button so you get notified when I publish more videos like this.